The Omen is a classic horror movie that has more than its fair share of real-life terror attached to it. The film is about a boy called Damien, who, after a series of mysterious happenings and violent events, is revealed to be the Antichrist. Robert Munger, the film's religious advisor and the man who had the idea for The Omen, is reported as having said, "If the devil's greatest single weapon is to be invisible, and you're going to do something which is going to take away his invisibility to millions of people, he's not going to want that to happen." And certainly, if reports are to be believed, it seems as though the devil did not want the movie to happen. Knowing that only bad might come from the film, Munger pursued the idea with missionary zeal, wanting people to know what the Bible said about the Antichrist. As early as October 1975, at the start of filming, the devil showed his displeasure. When the lead actor, Gregory Peck, was on his way to the UK to begin filming, his plane was struck by lightning and was very nearly sent to the bottom of the ocean, one of the plane's engines having caught fire. Weeks later, the producer was flying across the Atlantic when his plane was similarly struck. And, as if lightning striking twice wasn't enough for Lucifer, the screenwriter's plane was also hit by a bolt on a separate occasion, and the producer was nearly struck by lightning whilst filming in Rome. Lightning was not the only weapon employed by the curse. Incendiaries, it is claimed, were also used. The Hilton Hotel in London, where some of the crew were staying, was blown up, as was the restaurant where they planned to eat. The near misses did not end there. A small jet that was hired by the production company was changed last minute to accommodate a Chinese trade delegation. The plane experienced a bird strike and crashed into the car that held the family of the pilot. Six lives were lost that day. Of course, one could see the inverse of these near misses. Rather than being cursed, the film's production team experienced an extraordinary degree of good luck. Not everyone, however, can be said to have been so lucky. During filming at Windsor Safari Park, the car the actors were in did actually stall, and were indeed attacked by primates at the park. This terrifying and real scene is the one shown in the film. In addition to this, after filming finished at the park, one of the animal handlers that worked there was fatally attacked by a resident big cat. Then there was the horrific event that happened to the special effects designer John Richardson. He is said to have designed the scene in the film where one of the characters was decapitated. Reality imitated fiction during a car accident in the Netherlands. Richardson walked away, but his passenger did not, having met a similarly gruesome end to the one depicted in the film. Not only did this happen in the same year that The Omen was released, it supposedly occurred near a road sign that pointed to the city of Omen. Such a happening seems too chilling to be coincidental. Indeed, it is astonishing to see a film surrounded by so many tragedies. Some, like Hector Avalos, a professor of religious studies, has stated that the film was trying to make the devil visible, and so that's why Satan was trying to stop the film from being made.